So there are a couple of different clinical applications that really have come out, as I said, from a number of researchers in the telomere field. The first one was the fact that cancer cells have to divide so many more times than most normal cells have to divide. And so cancer cells have to solve this telomere problem. That is, if the telomere shorten progressively, those cancer cells won't divide. And we have had input in this area in showing that if you have a mouse that doesn't have telomerase, you can actually, in some certain cancer settings, you can protect the mice against these tumors. So that's one aspect, and I think that there's a lot of research going into the idea of potential telomerase inhibitors as a treatment for certain cancers. As we know, cancer isn't a single disease, so there's not going to be one particular treatment that's going to work in all cases, but in certain cases, it may be a fairly good approach. And then the other clinical application is in these diseases. The first one that was identified has a kind of a long name. It's called dyskeratosis congenita, where mutations in human patients were identified. And it turns out that these patients have bone marrow failure. That is, for the same reason that cancer cells need telomerase to be able to continue dividing, the normal cells in your body, especially the bone marrow, which has to divide so many times to regenerate the tissue, it turns out needs telomerase. And other tissues as well. Discovery was made here by Mary Armanios showing that idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis also limits the telomeres limit the cell division in that disease. So it turns out that there are a number of diseases that the telomeres have to be able to maintain, be maintained, and these diseases are associated with aging.